What's good, everyone? You're back with Jono for another quick math lesson. Today we're going to look at some harder examples of expanding and see where your teacher's trying to kind of mess you up to lose a couple marks in the test. So if you are struggling with expanding or you're a bit new to the topic, my last video did have some more kind of basic fundamentals just to make sure we're on top of it. So remember, if we're putting our arrows in, we're feeling confident with this. All you've got to do is multiply what's inside the bracket, both terms, by what's outside. So for this one here, we've got 5 multiplied by the a and multiplied by the minus 4. So this one would be equal to 5a minus 20. You're feeling great with that one, but unfortunately, maths teachers often have ways to try and trick you. So if you see a negative sign out the front, so outside the brackets, please slow down. This is only there to annoy you and see if you can make a mistake. So we're gonna have a look at this first example. So this minus 5 out the front is multiplied by everything within the brackets. So we're gonna throw our arrows in there as well. So we've got minus 5 times by x, and then minus 5 times by 2. So minus 5 multiplied by x is negative 5x, and then minus 5 times by positive 2 is negative 10. So this is where a lot of students make mistakes and lose easy marks. Okay, just slow down with that first arrow and you might be able to save yourself a bit of grief. So my pro tip for these ones is put the arrow in front of the negative, okay? So you can see up here, I put my arrow's coming from that minus 5, just to make sure I don't forget to put it into both terms. If you are struggling with this, I would highly recommend if you throw this at the front, we'll do it for the second term, if you throw this at the front, that minus 5 times by plus 2, you can put that in your calculator and you won't have to do any work. You'll just see that second number change and you'll be sweet. So we're gonna have another example when there's negative inside the brackets as well. So for this one, we've got our minus 6 multiplied by 2x. So the minus 6 times by 2 means that we are left with negative 12x. So I'll just put that a little bit lower, negative 12x. Then our minus 6 is multiplied by this second term. So the minus 6 is multiplied by not positive 3, but negative 3. So again, that's why I put my arrows so deliberately at the start of each term, just so if you're chucking into your calculator, you can see that it needs to be minus 6 times minus 3. So for this one, two negatives make a positive. So we have plus 18. And that's our final step. Remember, with these expanding questions, if you look at the second term, make sure it changes in a way that you would expect from the first term. So if there's a negative out the front there, it's always going to change the signs of the things inside it. So you might be able to just have a little hint to see if you're on the right track. Sometimes you're also going to get expanding questions where there's a pronumeral or a letter out the front. Some students find these a little bit confusing, but you're actually doing less maths than with numbers, which is awesome, okay? All we have to do is just jam the letter out the front into the two terms that are inside the brackets. So for this one here, we've got a times 2a plus a times 3. When we're multiplying pronumerals, we just count up how many letters are in each term. So for this one, we've got 2 times by a squared, because this a multiplied by this a gives us a square number. Then we have to add on 3 times that a at the front, which is just 3a. That's your final answer. No maths involved. You just have to put that letter into both terms. Just again, make sure that second term does change when it's multiplied by something. That 3 turning into a 3a means you know you've done it correct. For this second one, it's going to be a combination of the two skills that we've learnt, but we've got minus x So this minus x times is by 2y. So what's in that is we've got the negative sign stays with it, so minus 2. And then I've got an x and a y, so those go in there as well. That's all I have to do for the first term. Then this minus x multiplies by another minus x. So because we've got two negatives, they cancel each other out into a positive. So we've got plus, and there are two x's there, or x squared. That's our final answer for that one. So again, the maths behind this one isn't crazy hard, but just making sure that we're taking that negative into both terms is really annoying, basically. But it is something that will help you get marks all throughout high school. Thanks very much, guys, and I'll see you later. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Congratulations on taking some time to get better at this algebra. I know it can be a little bit difficult sometimes. If you do need some extra work, remember there are some free worksheets linked in the description below, as well as the notes that came from this video, so you don't have to pause it and scribble them down. If you do get a second, please like and subscribe to the channel, because there'll be new maths videos coming out every couple of days. Thanks so much. Have a good one.